Okay, Shalom sisters. Today I wanted to do a quick video on dressing modestly and why it's important. Number one I want to bring out is that we should dress modestly because it's commanded of us to. Also that, you know, we set an example of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah. We set an example of the Most High wherever we go. You know, when people see something different in us, they'll ask us, oh, what are you? You know, 9 times out of 10, a lot of people will ask, oh, what are you? Are you African or what are you? Like, they'll ask something dumb, something, you know, something just to even talk to you. They'll ask the question and, you know, you can probably say, no, I'm an Israelite, you know. I'm a daughter of Zion. You know, so we're supposed to carry ourselves differently, like princesses, very ladylike, very classy. I also want to add is when I go out places and I am dressed modestly, like, I mean, I just dress modestly, period. But when I do go out places, and that didn't sound right the way I said it, when I am dressed modestly, like I don't, but I do always dress modestly. But when I do go out places and the heathen will look at me, my husband even said it himself, like the heathen will look at me differently. Like, who is this girl? Like, why isn't she wearing leggings and a weave and sweatpants? Why is her hair wrapped in? She has like a headpiece on, and what's going on? Why does she have a skirt on, a long skirt? So it looks different. And it's also an example to set for women in the world. So when women in the world see that you're dressed modestly and they see, you know, you still got your, you know, depending on what you wear, like whatever your style is, you know, we the salt of earth. So you can dress it up. You can do whatever you want to do. Have your own style when you dress modestly. Whether you like wearing flats, you like wearing sneakers, you like wearing hoodies, you like wearing whatever it is that you like to wear, you can always fit that into being modest. And if you look up the definition of modesty, it's anything, the dress is anything below knee length. Anything above knee length isn't modest. So as long as you don't have anything, and that's just my opinion, but yeah, that's not modest if it's below knee length. Like if you look at all of our foremothers in the 16, 17, even like any time before 19, what was it like? Let's say the 1970s, like the late 1960s, women always wore skirts and dresses. It wasn't normal for women to wear pants. And some sisters say, oh, you can wear pants. But to me, this is what I don't get. Mouth is getting dry. But to me, my thing is that if it says that you can't wear that which pertaineth to a man, does that mean it's okay for a man to wear a skirt? That's what I always tell sisters when they try to say, no, I can wear pants. I can wear pants. What are you talking about? And I'm like, look, if you think that you get into the kingdom of heaven and you're going to be wearing pants, then you're sadly mistaken. You're sadly mistaken. You're not wearing pants in the kingdom. No, that sounds so dumb. What princess, even Disney, what princess wears pants? I don't get it. Like, that's, it's off. It's, you just want to do what you want to do. No. You're not pleasing your flesh. You won't wear pants. You can cause a brother to go off and sin like that. Like, that's ridiculous. Anyway, we didn't wear pants. We wore skirts and we wore dresses all the time. Another thing about dressing modestly is that you know it's immodest if you put it on. And you have to ask yourself, is this going to cause brothers to sin? Because that's evil and that's wicked. So if you're wearing something that could cause a brother to say, she look good, that's being real wicked. Because you're supposed to be real shamefaced and discreet. Meaning you covered up, you quiet, you to the side, you not saying nothing. You not all up in brothers' faces, immodest. No. That's immodest. And behaviors can be immodest as well. If you all up in a brother's face, hey, Shalom, Ak. Yeah, you like that unleavened bread I made? Like, no, sit down. Sit down, sis. Have a seat. Because now you're not being discreet. You know what I mean? So being modest is a behavior, and is dressing as well. You're not about to be, just because you got a caftan on and some fringes and a hair wrap, but you all up in brother faces. That's not modesty. That's not a Proverbs 31 woman. No, it's not. Sorry. What else? oh, you attract negative, you attract demons when you dress immodestly. For example, when you're in the world, I can honestly say when I was in the world, I got a lot of negative attention. But now that I'm in the world, I get positive attention, meaning that I'm attracting, positive spirits. Like, oh, you look very nice. I really like, where'd you get that skirt from? Or what are those on the bottom of your dress? Oh, they're fringes due to, numbers 15, 38. Like, these are fringes. And you can kindly explain to a woman what fringes are. When you're in the world, sometimes women will be looking at you like, it's like a jealousy thing. They get mad when they see you and you look good. Or it's just like a whole different plethora of spirits. You got men spirits on you. I mean, men spirits would try to, oh, can I talk to you for a minute? Ooh, you got women getting jealous because you got something that they don't. But when you modest, and it's a completely different vibe. It's a completely different spirit on you. I do want to add this one time. I'm sorry, guys. My mouth is so dry. So dry. So lock it. I do want to add this one time when I was in my congregation. And they were teaching at the harbor, Baltimore Harbor, and it was this little girl, her group of friends, her sister, her group of friends, and she had on a little skirt. And all I was thinking was, anything could happen to her. Like, if anybody came up to her and touched her, she would be upset. But you kind of bring it on. She brought it upon herself because she shouldn't have had it on at the end of the day. She didn't know. She was a young girl. She just didn't know no better. So the brother was actually bringing out being modest to her, and I was like, okay, cool, that's through the spirit, because I'm like, what does she have on? She's a young girl. And I spoke to her afterwards. She was only 15. So in the midst of her listening to the brother's teach, an older man, he had to at least be 50 years old. What was he doing on a skateboard? I don't know. He was a loser. Anyway, he was on a skateboard and he came past and act like he fell on a girl, but he slapped her butt. And she was so, like, I can just tell in her spirit, she was so heartbroken. She was so disturbed. And he sexually assaulted that girl in front of, like, everybody. It was very bad. And it was just, but she attracted that spirit because she wasn't dressed modestly. Now, mind you, she would have had a shawl on, long dress on, whatever it was to keep her covered up. She would have never attracted that demon to her for him to come over there and sexually harass her. I'm not saying that you can't get sexually harassed when you modest, because like I said, when you dress modestly, because modesty is a behavior as well. So if you out acting a damn fool, you loud, you ignorant, you in the streets, and you got a hijab on and a kaftan, and hey, you attracting spirits on you, because it's more than just modestly. Being modest is more than just an appearance. It's how you carry yourself. Yeah, she got sexually, assaulted. She went back to the hotel. She changed her clothes. So, and she came back out to listen. And she was like, yeah, I used to dress modestly when I was younger. I'm like, girl, you're only 15. What are you talking about? But she was like, yeah, I used to dress modestly when I was younger. And, oh, I just stopped. So, I was just happy that she went back in her hotel room to go put on some modest clothes. So that was like a wake-up call for her. That was really the Most High. So you can definitely attract negative spirits when you're not dressed modestly. And you can attract a man of the world, and you be caught up in a whole bunch of drama, a whole bunch of stuff, like, because he just lusting after your body. But a man of the Lord is not going to lust after your body. Most High willing, but he not going to lust after your body. Like it says in Tobit, he said, I take the sister to marry, to not lust after, but to marry, and that we grow old together. That's what a righteous man is going to do. A man in the world is when you all got your ass out and your boobs out and your panty line showing and your breast showing and you got a one piece on, you got your belly button showing, you're going to attract a nigga, pretty much. I guess that's all the points I gotta add. If you got big breasts, like, put a shawl on, put a scarf on, wrap a scarf around your whole face, wrap a scarf on. No real low V-neck shirts. Got your breast out. You at the Hebrew Summit. You walk around twitching. But just moving back and forth, and you got a damn tight dress, sundress on. You got brothers lusting after you. That's evil. You got to really check yourself as Israelite woman and say, hey, am I gonna cause a brother, even a man that's not even in the truth, to lust after me today by what I have on? And 9 times out of 10, if you got an axe, if it's modest, it's not modest. If it's skin hugging your skin, it's not modest. But with that being said, shalom, sisters. And if you got any examples, so I can. With that being said, if you got any tips for sisters, comment below. Like, comment, or subscribe. Share this video or my other videos. And most high willing, y'all have a good night. The water for watching. And like I said, the whole purpose of this video is for sisters struggling with modesty. And it's modesty is also a behavior, just not what you wear. So you still have to be discreet. You still have to be kept to yourself, quiet, just like an Israelite woman, not all up, all in men's faces, doing what you want to do. No, with a caftan on and some fringes. No, you still got to show that you're modest by behavior as well. With that being said, shalom, sisters, and love y'all, and thank you for watching. Shalom.